For many years, it was normal for Windows users to be local administrators on their machines. The need for local administrator was influenced by the fact that the Microsoft ecosystem needed administrator rights in order to install and run software. For those of you that remember when Windows 7 first came out and the UAC, user account control, it was a controversial setting. It was actually put in place as a long-term program to get developers to not demand administrator rights. And to remind us users, and honestly buyers of software, to demand that our developers do a better job. As the years have gone by, we've gotten more used to running without administrator rights. But every now and then I still see applications that demand this. Now, Twitter is sometimes controversial itself, but also I find it a very good place for conversations about security. And the other day I found a tweet by Sean Metcalf, and he talked about the topic of why users should not have local administrator rights to the workstation. And here's some of the reasons that he gave. Number one, it makes it easier for an attacker to gain a foothold on the system. If they have administrator rights, they can compromise the ASS account, local service management automation, for more credentials. Number two, it makes logging more complicated. It makes for chattier event logs. If all users don't have local administrator rights, you can look for event 4672. If users are administrators, monitoring for this activity makes it practically useless. Number three, when the user has local administrator rights, ransomware has all the access it needs to totally brick a system and possibly go farther inside your network. And last, but certainly not least, if you've set up your network where the local administrator password is the same throughout your entire organization, all it takes is the attacker to pop that credential and they can do lateral movement throughout the entire network. If you haven't downloaded already, I highly recommend that you download the Local Administrator Password Solution, or LAPS, toolkit. This allows you to set up a system where randomly generated passwords are set up as that local administrator password. It's centrally managed, so you can still gain access should you need to deploy software, install things, you name it, but it doesn't have the same local administrator password throughout the network. If you still run your network that way, it's very dangerous. Attackers are looking for that weakness, and they will go after you and nail you. Now, if you've thought the user account control in Windows 7 and Windows 10 is a protection device, think again. Again, it was only set up to force our developers to move away from using local administrator rights. There's actually attack sequences that will use weaknesses in UAC. There's, on GitHub, UACme. It defeats user account control by abusing the built-in Windows Auto Elevate backdoor. And recently, an attacker disclosed that there's almost 300 Windows 10 executables vulnerable to DLL hijacking. One simple VBS script may be enough to allow users to gain administrative privileges and bypass UAC. So now that we know local administrator on the desktop is not a good thing, what else do we need to protect in our environment? On the cloud side, what about the global administrator? The keys to the kingdom, as I call it. Back to Sean Metcalf, back in 2019, he talked about that he was investigating Office 365 and Azure AD and found a weakness in there. If the global administrator account is compromised, an attacker can toggle a role called access management for Azure resources. If this access is toggled in the admin console, it adds the account to the user access administrator role in Azure RBAC at the root scope. Bottom line, it allows the attacker to get way into your Azure access and cause real issues inside your network. So how can you protect yourself from this? Well, there's two ways. Way number one is, of course, and I'm going to say this over and over again until you guys all do it, is ensure you have multi-factor authentication on your global administrator accounts in particular, and all user accounts on all roles that are in Office 365. So everyone from A to Z in your organization should have multi-factor authentication on every Office 365 account. Next, you'll want something called Privileged Identity Management, or PIM. Now, it does need additional licensing. You'll need an Azure AD Premium 2 or an E5, but you don't have to have this one throughout your entire organization. So only your global admin accounts need this license. So a P2 or an E5 for your global admins, and you want to turn on what's called PIM. What PIM does is set up a process where activities are approved and logged so you can actually track them better. So for example, you can configure a privilege access management policy that requires explicit approval to access and change organization mailbox settings in your tenant. So it's key that you look to see to enable this and also turn on auditing. And again, I cannot stress this enough. For Office 365 users and every single global administrator, you want to make sure that you have multi-factor authentication. Remember that you can either use the Microsoft Authenticator app, Google's Authenticator app, you can also use key fobs. I personally find that the Microsoft Authenticator app on my iPhone is the easiest way. Most everyone has an iPhone or a smartphone in their pocket. If someone doesn't have a smartphone, there are other ways you can implement multi-factor, including a phone callback, a text message. And remember that you've probably heard in the news where multi-factor authentication based on text messages may not be secure, but anything that takes you out of the low-hanging fruit range is better than nothing at all. So yes, there have been attacks against text messages, but usually they're targeted and they're high targets. And I'm guessing since most of you are not Department of Defense or other high military targets, you can probably get away with just the normal Authenticator app. So remember, is all MFA foolproof? Absolutely not. But doing any form of multi-factor takes you out of the reach of most attackers. Your goal is to not be 100% secure. Your goal is to be just a little more secure than the guy down the street so that the attackers go down after the guy down the street. So take the time to look at Privileged Identity Management, or PIM. Audit your network and make sure you don't have any local administrators. And if you do, make sure that you've set up the Local Administrator Password Toolkit, or LAPS. And last but certainly not least, check us out on the IDG Tech Talk YouTube channel. And until next time, this is Susan Bradley for CSO Online. Stay safe, stay well, and stay a little bit more secure than your next door neighbor.